Lot of studies have been done how the power shift is taking place in the last few years. India was an eminent country occupying a very important place in the international trade till 1820-1830. We were not a laggard in that sense. Whatever had happened only after 1830, 1840, it has happened, and definitely after 1857. Slowly we lost our independence and we lost our self-rule and we lost the leadership role. Now that situation is changing. We have to clearly understand that situation is changing. We have problems. We have even different sectors of crisis, but the crisis or the problems can never be compared to the problem of 1820 or 1850 or 1910. So we have to understand there is a clear change. India is a very important country at the global level, and in coming, if you see the next 25 years, without Indian play, Indian role, no global architecture can be constructed. This we have to understand. Global architecture to facilitate, to govern, to regulate trade, or to regulate the flow of technology, or to regulate the flow of knowledge process, or if you see the administrative architecture. In all these aspects, Indian role is very important in that context. The population of India is a very important component. Today, we have here the media and the people, because we have invited a politician, a general secretary of the political party. Now, I am interacting in the last few days in south, north, in different places. Wherever I go, I am experiencing a different situation. Sometimes the enthusiasm and expectations among the business people much more compared to the BJP cadres. You cannot have an alternative without BJP becoming the core. This is not because I belong to BJP, I am saying. This is the political situation, this is the political reality. Many people, many political parties now, day in, day and day out, they are trying to say that we are alternative and BJP is not the alternative. But the next day, that getting dissolved. That structure is getting dissolved. There is no guarantee that the assertion which has come from that quarter is going to be there after a fortnight. All over the country, many people started saying that we will be able to emerge as the largest party with 165, 170, now reached 175, 180, 190, 200. Now people started speculating, now what is the score at this point of time? It is 220. So as we near the election schedule, definitely I hope with your support and with your endorsement, BJP would be able to not only emerge as the largest party, but 272 plus mission will be achieved with full success. People want all over the country a stable government, a government which is capable of delivering, and a government which has got a leader in whom people have faith and trust. That is the reason slowly BJP is extending its frontiers of acceptance. See, in Hyderabad, the situation also will become conducive day by day. Whatever the confusion is there and doubts are there, all those doubts will be removed very soon, and we will become a force here also. And my expectation from this meeting are important people and a new sector which is giving the, which is the, you know, ultimately at the core of Indian pride today. IT sector is at the core of Indian pride. So, a sector where you have the confidence at the at its full highest level. If you go to agriculture, you have the confidence at the lowest level. And if you go to IT sector, whatever the confidence, you have the problems, but the level of the confidence at the highest level. So this sector has to give full yes to this kind of ambition and this kind of drive. So from this, I expect ideas in that direction. And definitely, BJP will come out with a manifesto where IT sector is a very important sector for this growth. And establishing the high trajectory growth or reviving the industry and reviving the manufacturing sector and creating the IT sector as a driver of economy. All these are the important driving points for BJP. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.